Hey techies and all the data enthusiasts there. So guys, welcome you all to my YouTube channel. This is video 5 of Azure OpenAI series, and in this particular video, we are going to see how can you generate codes with Azure OpenAI. Means in this particular video, we are going to explore the module where you can generate codes with the help of Azure OpenAI, and also how can you improve your code. Okay. So guys, now let's not waste our time. Let's dive into my computer screen and discuss more about this particular topic. Before that, I want to share you important information to you all. I'm making this video mainly to explain you all in a video format, because the course which you see, it is not in a video format. Everything is in a text. So I'm creating it to explain to the people who doesn't understand this. Okay, please do remember this. And it doesn't make any sense only if you copy the solution from the video and if you complete and get the certification, because at the end of the day, you should know how to implement it practically, right? So guys, make sure to concentrate on this. And if you are already completed the course and if you are attending the final assessment, right, of 2 hours assessment, so make sure to try it again. If you fail, it's not a problem, because this is a free course only and there is no any deadline, right? Try to complete the assessment and then get the certification. I'll definitely upload the solution at the last, but I want you all to try and complete the solution and get certification. Let us see how many of them will complete it by the end of this particular series. So the last video will be the solution video. So now we are at the fifth video actually. Okay. So more 3 videos are there. After that, I'll upload the solution video. So before that, let us see how many of them are going to complete and they are going to share the certification. So definitely share the certification in LinkedIn and tag me if you all feel my course interesting. Okay, this particular Azure OpenAI series. Now let us dive into my screen and discuss more about this particular topic. Before that, if you are not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe to the channel and on the bell notification. So now let's move. So guys, here you all can see, right? So we are already done with getting started with Azure OpenAI, building the solutions and applying prompt engineering with Azure OpenAI. Okay, all these are done. Now we are in generating code with Azure OpenAI. So this doesn't take much time. Go to introduction. So let me just show you all the introduction. So this is a basic module. Okay, you can say in Azure OpenAI service enables you to use LLMs to generate content, including programming codes. This functionality allows developers to generate and improve existing program code in various language, increase efficiency and understanding. Okay. And here you can see construct code with natural language. One of the capability of Azure OpenAI model is to generate the natural language prompts. Okay. And tasks can range from a simple one line command to a full application. Okay. There is a capability for it. So for this, you all can see here AI model for code generation. In previous generation of GPT models, some were trained especially to use code, okay, and they were often called as codex models. As new generation of models involved in basic model drastically improve their performance and understanding the both language and code. So previously the models which were designed, right, they were mainly focusing on code. So for example, you can take GitHub Copilot. If you see Copilot previously when it was first launched and compared to now, it has drastically improved its accuracy. It's 10x more performance good compared to the first version which they launched. Okay, so that's all about this. And we can use the model such as GPT-4 or GPT-3.5 Turbo. Okay, it's of our choice. And now the function here, write a function. You can give a prompt here. This is a prompt. Yeah, this is a prompt. Write a function for binary search in Python. So you can see here the code is here and the explanation of it. This is a ChatGPT's code. You can see in ChatGPT, you will get like this. First, it will provide you the code. Then it is going to explain the same way in challenge, change coding language. Okay, you can also directly ask to change the coding language also. It's all about it. You can simply write here print squares and you can tell it to change, convert it to C language from Python to C hash. So it can easily convert it C sharp. Okay. Understand unknown code. So you will be facing many complex situations. So some complex code will be like which you will not be able to understand when it comes to your normally when you are building an application also. Somewhere if you are not able to understand a function which previously some other person has written in your organization, you can copy it, you can ask to the bot or else you can say the ChatGPT or even the Azure Copilots and you can get the explanation from it. What this particular code is doing, they can detail it, break it and explain it. So that is the main capability of this AI model. So you all can use this as an advantage. I hope many of them will already be using it. Complete code and assistance to development access. So we are using Python, okay, for this particular course. Complete partial code, okay. Azure OpenAI models are capable of generating code based on comments, function names, or partially written code. So you can see here, complete the following function. Calculate the average of a number in an array, but only if there are even, okay, they are even. So you can see here, and he just mentioned a def, okay, he didn't write anything. So when you gave def, it got to know that, okay, this is a function. So this is a function, so it wrote a code here. You can see I generated a code based on that particular def function only, okay. If def is not mentioned, might be you get a different result, who knows, okay. The same way, similar functionality can be used in providing a partial code to the model without any comments. Take the following prompt as an example. Complete the following code, def function 1, n, if n double equal to 0. Then it will complete the code, return 1, else return n into function 1 of n minus 1. Okay. And to write unit tests. Okay. To write unit tests, what you can do? Write 3 unit tests for this particular function. So it will write the unit tests for that accordingly. Okay. You all can see here. Simple code. This is how you normally can write it. It breaks the code and it writes the unit test based on it. Okay. Okay. It breaks in a sense. It executes the code. And then based on that, it is going to give you the unit tests. Okay. Add comments, so you can add comments for everything in this particular code, what particular line is doing, and even you can add multi-line comments also. This is a multi-line comments, okay. So that's all. When you go to the practical implementation, you will get it more detail. So fixing bugs and improving your code, okay. When it comes to fixing bugs and improving the code, you can see here, Azure OpenAI models can fix bugs in code by analyzing the code and struggling changes that can potentially fix the issue. This can help developers identify and resolve bugs faster and more efficiently. Okay, for this you can take an example of def calculate average number total is equals to 0 for I in range length of numbers. Okay. This is a working calculate average to calculate the average code. Okay. This is working code. Now you can give a prompt. Provide the function to the model along with the prompt. Fix the bug in this particular function. If you just mention fix the bug in this particular function, it is going to execute the code at the back end. The GPT models will execute and they check it. Or if there is already available in the trained model, it is going to provide that. But here you can see where is the bug in this. You can tell me. So the last line return average is wantedly made a mistake. So you can see here it rectifies it. Okay, you can see here and it gives a description. There are totally 3 mistakes. It is giving that. Okay. So return spelling and average I told you all and total. Improve performance. So this is a normal code and you can write it. The version works correctly, but its time complexity is O of N. Please provide the model. Here, this is a response. We can improve this function by using a mathematical formula instead. Here isn't some efficient version. So the AI model is giving you the output. So for this, O of 1. So the time complexity is O of 1 for this, and this is O of N. So here the time complexity is more right compared to this. So for that, we can use this particular code. You can use it to reduce the time complexity also to your code. And there are many other, you can see here, many other examples are there. You can explore it. Now let us directly dive into the exercise solution. The same way, we are not going to launch the lab, because if you launch the lab also, you have to log in with your Azure OpenAI credentials only. Instead of that, you can directly click on exercise instructions here. And you can start using this. Okay. So this is my previous Azure OpenAI service, and you can see a previous like created, right? That is available here. So let me first open it. I'll open this and I'll use this only. Okay. I'm not going to make any changes right now. So let us see the instructions here. So go to the portal. Okay. And we have created it. So previously I already created the Azure OpenAI, this one. This particular, whatever instance you are seeing, this is already created. So if you have not watched my previous video, you can check that. I have shown you all how can you create it and how can you create the deployments also. Okay. So I have GPT 3.5 Turbo 16K, 3.5 Turbo 16K model already running in that model also. So, okay, I can use that only then. Can see here, and deployments, I have 16K model running already. So here what it's saying, first you have to set up and chat session. In chat session, okay, you have to go to chat session and you have to give this prompt there. Okay, you have to edit this. So let me just copy this. What it is saying, set up and go to chat session, and in configuration, use the configuration settings for this model deployment. Okay, let me open, go to chat. Okay, so I'm at the chat page here. You can see here in the configuration, deployment is proper, so it is 16K only. Here in the setup page, here you can see here, select the template, it is there, right? You can give it here. You can select default, okay, continue. And here you can see here, you are an AI assistant that helps people find information, right? Remove this system message and replace it. You are a programming assistant helping to write the code, okay? So select this and then save it. Save, continue. So now this is applied. Now what you have to do, let us go back here. So you can see here, once that is done, in the chat session, it is asking me to give this particular prompt. Let me copy this and give here. Write a function in Python that takes a character and a string as input and returns how many times the characters appears in a string. Okay. So I can just press enter. So you can see here, it is giving me the output here. So it took a string and it is going to return. You can see here the particular word A, character A. In this particular word, it returns 3 times. So in the word banana, okay. You can see here, you can see the code is perfectly working. If you click on JSON view, you can view everything in JSON. We don't require that also. If you click on view code here, you can view the entire code here. You can directly copy this particular code of Azure OpenAI and you can paste it there. So you can see a role and the prompt and everything is mentioned here. And even the completion, everything is there. The code you can see here, Python code, or you can even select any of the code which you want. Okay. Click on the clear chat to clear this chat. Okay. And let me go back and let us see. Next, send the prompt. Do the same thing, but write it in C language. Okay. So let me run that again. I cleared it, right? Okay, now let me copy that prompt. Do the same thing, but write it in C sharp language. Let me send it. You can see the model writes it in C sharp language. Public int count character character string str and the code of it. Okay. So now next comes, now let's explore using AI to understand the code. Submit the following code and it is asking me to submit this particular prompt. Okay, so I'll submit the code now. First let me send the code, or you can directly give it also. So this is done, right? So I can copy this here. Can you simplify the function? I guess it should work, or else we have to send along with it. Now we have to send it along with that. So let me just copy that. It's basic actually. We have to normally send the prompt along with the code only. I thought the model has the remember capabilities. You can change the prompt. You can ask the code which I have sent previously, right? So based on that, you can give me a function. Can you simplify the function? But let us normally ask it. I'm not changing the prompt. How they gave, the same way I gave it. Okay, so the code was about multiplication only. So it gave us previously correctly only. Now also you all can see here, it is giving us correctly only. In just three lines, it is done instead of writing this much of code. Now also you can say that add some comments to this particular function. So you can just copy. I guess this will take in that function and give it. Okay, so it is adding all the comments you can see here. Okay, checks if the result should be negative or written accordingly. So it's there. Nice. Now let us use the same thing in Visual Studio Code. Let us try out with Visual Studio Code. Okay, so using this interface is just for your understanding. Normally when it comes to the production ready code, you have to write everything in VS Code only. You have to configure this in VS Code only. So this understanding is done. Right now, let us go to VS Code and check the code. Okay. So I already cloned their GitHub repo, this particular GitHub repo. If you haven't cloned it, make sure copy this and clone it, because the code template is already available. You will be just adding some functions in that. Okay. And you can understand it very soon. So guys, I already opened my VS Code. You all can see here, I already cloned it. So we are going to use the same. So let me just activate the base first. Base is already there, so let us activate my VNV. Okay, I activated it. So I already created this particular VNV in the first second video itself. You can go and have a look on that if you don't know how to create a VNV. This VNV will help you all to keep all the dependencies only for this particular project, because if you install those dependencies in your laptop directly in every places, so there is a chance that one dependency works for one project and for another it is different. The version issues might be there. So for that you have to always use VNV. Okay, that's the best approach. Okay, now let us go back to our Visual Studio Code. Pip install OpenAI is already done. And add the following code service model. Okay, so before that, let me just open that code generation and I'll select Python VENV. So you can see my VENV here. I haven't set the API endpoints and everything. Now I need to set that. So let us go back to our portal. So we'll be using the Python code. Okay. And let me go back to this and open AI YT. So I'll just click on this key and endpoints. Okay. Show the key. It's not a problem. If the key is exposed also, definitely I'll delete this account once the video is done. So you will not be able to access this key and URL. So I'm just showing you all the key. Okay. Okay, key is done and endpoint. Let me copy the endpoint. Let me paste the endpoint here. And deployment name. So our deployment name was, you can see here, the deployment name was GPT-16K. Okay, so let me mention that GPT-16K. Okay, so now this is ready. Let me go back to this. Okay, so this looks fine. Now what else is there? Configurations are already done, you can see here. So this endpoint os.getenv, so from env it takes this, and that things are configured here properly. So you can see the commands here, and here you can see format and send the request to the model. So you need to write the code here, the code which is already available in this particular exercise here. So let me copy this code, paste it here, and let me just it proper. So now this is added into the function. You can see here role, system message, user message, and chat completion and its temperature. You can see here now once that is done, what they are telling to run the code now first. Okay, so this is done. So it got saved. I enabled auto save. Okay, so I don't need to click Control S. So make sure you all also enable auto save. So next target is, let me check where I am right now. Where is my VNV? So it is in the base environment. I should come to lab files, and then I have to come to this 04 code generation and Python. So let me come to this particular, let me copy the path, cd. Bash cd. No search directory found. Oh, let me go to you. Okay, let me copy the relative path. No search file or directory. Okay, cd lab files. Okay, I got it. Let me just remove this. Okay, so the issue was with the backslash. So backslash should not be there when you copy the relative path. Make sure change it to the forward slash. Okay, that's done. Now let me clear the screen first. I mean the previous terminal actions. So let me take this up. Now here, Python run. So code, right? Code generation.py. Oh. Okay, I don't need to mention the run, it was by mistake. Okay, it is asking add comments to my function. So let me just give it one. Enter a prompt. So let us go back and see there. Prompt. Choose option one. It is saying choose option and copy this prompt. Let us go back. Add comment to the following function. Return only the command commented code. Okay, enter. Okay, so the response is now saved in results.txt. So you can see here the commented code is here. Okay, so let me just remove this if you want. And again, let us go with the same. Let me close this first. Here again, it shows the response is saved in this. So you can see here it came. So commenting is done. What is next? So choose option 2 and write unit tests for the same function. Okay, unit tests. Let me copy the prompt. You can see here the unit tests are here. So it got, so it gets overwritten. So once you run it, so it overwrites whatever existing response is there and it gives you this particular code. Okay, now this fix my Go Fish game and quit. This I want you all to do it. You can see here, fix the code below for an app. I play Go Fish with the user, written only the correct code. So this will give you all, but I want you all to try this one response. So if you try, you will definitely understand how it works. So once everything done, you have to clean it up. So I'm not going to clean it because I have to submit the send this to you all, right? So let me just go to .env and I'll remove this. Okay, I'll remove this endpoint. Now let me commit this code in front of you all. So I'll just add it to stage, add it, and finally this is 5, right? Okay, I'll just commit this. Think the changes. Okay, so changes synced, it's done. Now you all can see. Okay, so guys, the exercise is done. Now let us go with the knowledge check. In the previous video also I missed the knowledge check because there we got some error at the last, but that is updated. That is updated. You can go and have a look in my code. Okay, what are some benefits of using Azure OpenAI to generate code? Increase in efficiency and productivity, increase in bug and readability, increase in time spending code. So let me select increase in efficiency and productivity. Okay, what is the purpose of providing more context to the Azure OpenAI model when completing the partial code? So providing more context makes the model less accurate. Providing more context doesn't affect the accuracy of the model is wrong. The more context provided to the model, the more accurate the response likely to be. Okay, this is the one. What is an example of how Azure OpenAI models can change coding language? Models can only translate code from one language to another if the code is written in C hash. No. If you have code in one language but need it to written in another, Azure OpenAI can translate that for you in several languages. Yes, that can be done. It can only translate it in Python, C Sharp and Java. Then what about JavaScript and other language? So I select option 2. Let us see which is correct out here. Oh, all are correct. So that's all. Finally, click on complete module and this module is done. Once you are done with this, you get this achievement option. You can directly share this achievement in your LinkedIn. Okay. So in this video, I explained these things very clearly. Okay, guys. So let us meet you all in the 6th video of Azure OpenAI series. Thank you all. Bye-bye. And if you all like this particular video, do comment below how was this particular video.